This is artist Andre Trump with one of his pictures. He brought it all the way from California to try to stump our panel on What's My Line? And now let's meet this week's panel, Soupy Sales, Donna Valery, Jerry Orbach, Arlene Francis, and the host of What's My Line, Larry Blyden.
Hey, we say Larry.
Hello, all bodies. Well, listen, I tell you, it looks like a very sportif day today. Everybody's very cash.
We're going to have a cash
Very
guest.
Cash. Yes, yes. And we have kind of a fun thing, and the first thing we have will, with any luck at all, puzzle you. Would our first challenger enter and sign in, please?
Andre Trump.
Where are you from?
Los Angeles.
Okay, Los Angeles. Andre Trom is an artist panel, and that's one of his pictures there. And you are to figure out how it was made, but before you try, let's show the audience. And let's begin with Donna Valeri.
Did you paint over a very unusual substance? Is that what you did?
No.
One down, nine to go, Jerry.
Does the unusual quality of your painting have to do with how you do it more than what you do it with?
Not really. Two down, eight to go, Arlene.
Is the substance that you used something... is it ground down to be like sand?
No.
Three down, seven to go, Soupy.
Is it indeed sand?
No.
Four down, six to go, Donna.
Is this substance that natural color, or did you color the substance that you used to paint?
Now, you asked two questions. Ask one and that we can answer yes or no.
Oh, okay. Did you have to color the substance that you used to paint that?
Yes.
When the substance is in its original form, is it a hard substance?
Yes.
Did you have to melt it down?
No.
Five down, five to go, Jerry.
And you didn't have to grind it down?
No.
But it's hard.
Hmm?
Hmm. You don't brush that substance on, do you?
No.
No. Wait. Six down and four to go, Arlene.
Funny, I can rule out that it's eggshells, can't I?
Yes.
Is the substance a natural substance?
Yes.
So that it is something from nature that we are looking at, huh?
Right.
Is it something that is found in the soil?
Yes. Yes.
Well, it's not pebbles, I can't. Is it something that you'd find near a beach?
It would depend on where you were. There's some places where you could find that substance near a beach, and there's some places where you couldn't.
Uh-huh. Can I rule out that it's any shell of any fish or anything like that?
Yes, I can rule that out.
I can rule that out. Is it anything that was ever alive?
No, not really. Seven down, three to go, Soupy.
If you wanted to find the substance around your house, would it be found mostly in the kitchen?
Yes.
Would it be a condiment of some kind? Like salt?
No. Eight down, two to go, Donna.
Is this edible when it's in its original form?
Yes.
Is it a fruit or a vegetable?
I guess it's
yes.
Is it sugar?
No.
No.
Nine down and one to go, Jerry.
Could I just pick this up cold and eat it in its natural form?
No, you'd have to do something to it in order to do it. Vegetable is fairly loose definition that I gave to it, in that it is vegetable rather than animal or mineral. What it is, folks,
is
rice.
Oh, rice.
Ah. It's rice. Now, how do you do that?
Well, first you have to color dye the rice with closed dye.
With what?
Closed dye.
Closed dye?
Closed dye.
Yeah.
All the color you want. Then you...
You mean like all-purpose red or something like that?
Yeah, anything.
Really?
Yeah.
Then what?
Then you just glue it on one by one.
One by one with the tweezers?
One by one with a tweezer.
How long does it take to do that?
I'm not finished yet. Oh, like this size, about 250, maybe 300 hours.
You could have decorated
it. Goodness, how many grains of rice are in there?
Oh, but... I'd say about 25,000.
25,000 grains of rice. Why, folks, you could feed an orphanage for a week.
Why didn't you use minute rice?
Save time.
Very good, sir.
All right.
Where did you learn to do that?
I was looking for a hobby, and I thought of that, and it worked.
Well, he's brought some more with him, so could we open the curtain, Lloyd, please, and we'll see some more of Mr. Trom's work.
Look at that.
That's marvelous.
Yeah.
Do you draw or sketch on the thing first, and then...
Well, some I did, and some other. I can just go over any picture, like the trout there. That's an old picture I bought at the Goodwill people.
We bought it at the Goodwill and then just
and
went
just
over it with that?
Covered it up with rice.
Oh, I see.
Here's one that's really kind of fun that I got here. I'm sort of a clown freak. And look at this one. Isn't this good? Can you get a shot
lovely.
Of this, Lloyd?
That's Emmett.
Isn't that good?
Yeah.
Listen, it's really a fascinating thing that you're doing, and congratulations. We never met anybody who did that before. Good luck to you, Mr. Charles. We'll be back with more of What's My Line after this message. And it's time for our next challenger to enter and sign in, please. Barbara Paul. Where are you from?
Monticello, New York.
Okay. Panel, Barbara Paul provides a service, and we'll show our audience what her line is. And let's begin with Jerry Orbach.
Could this service be used by both men and women?
Yes.
Is it done in the home?
No.
One down, nine to go, Arlene.
Miss Paul, would you be a performer of any sort?
No.
Two down, eight to go, Soupy.
Are you involved in any sports of any kind?
Indirectly, yes.
When you say indirectly, does that mean that you might be a referee or umpire or a field judge rather than a player?
No.
No.
Three down, seven to go, Donna.
I may be wrong,
but
I think you're wonderful.
I think there's a racetrack there. Do you take bets?
That's it. She's a paramedic full court. That's so fast and so unruly that we're just going to throw them all over.
Yeah.
That's almost
fantastic.
Rude. Barbara is employed to take bets at Monticello Raceway in Monticello, New York. What window do you work?
The $10 perfecta and the $18 box window.
What is a fecta?
It's a perfecta.
What is a perfecta?
A trifecta. You have to pick the win and place horse exactly in the race. And the trifecta, you have to pick three in a row.
See, that's a fecta. Why do they call it, why does it have fecta on the end of it? How did it get that, you know?
That's the name that they gave it. Well, it's an exact bet. It would be winning place exactly. So it's rather exotic.
How much money a day comes over that window, would you say?
Oh, I would say 20,000.
That's not bad, folks. It's a pleasure to meet a lady through whose hands $20,000 a day goes to somebody. Thank you for being with us on What's My Line. We'll be back with more of What's My Line after this message. And it's time now to play a little round of Who's Who. Just before we went on the air, we were lucky enough to persuade four people from our audience to play with us. And would the team please come down now? There they come. Okay, one of these, ladies and gentlemen, is a chandelier manufacturer, one a safety engineer, one a research interviewer, and one a nurse. All you have to do is hand out the card so that each person is holding the card which correctly states his or her occupation. You have about 20 seconds apiece. We'll start with Soupy Sales. On your mark, get set, go. Donna, when you're hot, that's all.
Boy,
would you tell us who you are, please?
Yes, I'm Susan Sharkey. I'm a nurse at Mountainside Hospital in Montclair, New Jersey.
I'm not sure they heard all that. Would you say it again?
I'm Susan Sharkey. I'm a nurse at Mountainside Hospital in Montclair, New Jersey.
Thank you. It wasn't your fault that they didn't hear you. The mic wasn't there. Okay.
Jerry Rowan from Toronto, Ontario, and I manufacture chandeliers.
Okay.
Bob Jones, safety engineer, Salinas, California.
Okay.
Dorothy Schmieder from St. Louis, marketing interviewer.
Okay. You've won $25. We have a special gift for each of you, and thank you for playing Who's Who on What's My Line. Thank you.
Yes, each member of the Who's Who team receives a Samsonite Classic 3 attaché with the exclusive safety latch designed to eliminate the accidental spilling of the case's contents. The Classic 3 attaché from Samsonite. Larry.
Okay, we're back, and it's time now for the special feature of What's My Line, the appearance of our mystery guest. So that means it's blindfold time, panel. Are they all in place?
They certainly are.
Then would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? Okay, panel, we'll go one question at a time. Fate's law prevails. You have about 2 minutes, and let's start with Soupy Sales.
Thank you. Well, that was a rousing ovation, mystery guest. Is that because they know your work from records in the nightclub feel?
Yes, I would say so.
Donna?
Do we also know you because of your television appearances?
Somewhat.
Jerry?
She's not disguising her voice.
Have you had your own television show in the last couple of years?
No, I have not.
Arlene?
Records in the nightclub field, does that mean that you are a very popular singer?
Yes.
Okay.
Soupy?
Ooh. Well, when you do, are you a brunette?
No, I'm not.
Donna?
Have you had a hit record within this year?
Yes, I have.
Jerry?
Boy, part about not having your own television show throws me because I want to take a guess. If I'm wrong, I guess I'll have to take off my mask.
That's right.
Is it Helen Reddy?
No, now you have to take off your
okay.
mask.
So
you
I'm just
have
like
no idea how far off you are.
Are Arlene? You, let's see, are you a rock singer?
No, I'm not.
Soupy? I'll tell you, those of you who are left with your masks on, that we are not messing around.
I'm hip. Do you sing? Are you very big in the country western field?
No, not yet.
Donna?
That would be nice.
Not country western. It's got to be an opera singer, then.
I know who it is if you want to know.
Thanks a lot. I wish you would.
You want to pass, Donna?
Yeah, I can't think of another field.
Arlene?
Well, are you a blues singer?
I do sing blues, yes.
Soupy?
Oh.
Did you record for Capitol?
No, I don't.
Donna?
Are you appearing in New York right now?
No, not presently.
Arlene?
Oh.
I'm having such fun over here.
Hurry, Arlene.
I can't. Are you hip?
You are gonna...
I'm gonna kill myself, yeah. I know.
Yeah.
All right, I'll pass to Soupy. He knows
Soupy?
Everything.
No, were you on Broadway in the last 6 or 7 months?
No.
Donna?
Do you play the piano?
Yes, I do.
Arlene?
While you sing?
Sometimes.
Arlene?
Oh.
I just can't get over
it. It's somebody big. I know it's somebody big.
Had a hit.
Go ahead, Soup.
I just want to take a guess at it. Is it Hazel Scott?
No, now you can take off your mask. Yeah.
Ah, yeah, yeah. My favorite.
All right, the time is up, folks. You're not going to believe it. This is Aretha Franklin. I just think nobody could believe you were here, and that's what really happened.
I thought Soupy would guess that.
I have 8 of your albums, and I just play them all the time.
You are so thin.
A little bit.
What occurred?
Not too much. attitude and determination.
How much did you take off?
About 20 or 25 pounds.
That's terrific. How long did it take?
About 3 to 4 months.
That's really sensational.
Does it affect your singing?
No, not really.
You know, there's a theory that if you're heavier, it makes your voice richer. Your voice has not changed.
I thought that for a moment, but I found that really not to be true.
When you're singing a song, what is the main thing you try to do?
Feel it.
Well, you feel it and you make us feel it, too. I mean, it's unbelievable what you do. How did you learn to sing that way? Is it just native to you? It's in you? Or did you learn from someone? Were you influenced by someone?
No, I think it was...
I mean, you're really one of a kind.
Somewhat natural, and I did sing in the young people's choir in my father's church.
Yeah.
I started there, and from there, here.
You know, it's marvelous when somebody with a really gigantic talent at anything comes around. And it's a hard question to ask, I'm going to ask you, but what do you think talent is?
What do I think talent is?
Because you got so much of it, you must have some notion.
You got something going on.
Did you study music? Are you like...
No, I didn't.
Can you read?
No, I don't. I can read a melody line somewhat, but I don't read music.
Then how can you play?
By ear.
That's incredible and the most depressing thing I ever heard in my life.
Sure, you go and study and study and kill yourself and you wind up with nothing, right?
Well, Errol Garner couldn't read and he plays some.
Uh-huh.
Hmm?
That's true.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then he studied for a while. Now, what is it, if you could do anything you want to do, and I suspect that you now are in a position to do anything you want to do, what would it be?
To keep on doing what I'm doing and do it good.
You know, we in New York... We in New York are so hungry to have you come here and perform, and it just seems like you are never here. Are you going to ever come here and do something for us?
Yes, I am. I was just in the Apollo in March, and very possibly we'll be at Radio City. I certainly hope so.
You know, I think it's marvelous that you play the Apollo, because an awful lot of people, when they get big in the black community, stop playing there, and it's a mistake. But I wish you'd come uptown and play with us some, too.
Of course.
Will you?
Come downtown.
I mean, downtown, yeah. Listen, You are the best.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming on the show. We'll be back with more of What's My Line after this message. You know, the extraordinary thing about sitting here with Aretha Franklin is that when she looks at you, she really looks at you. And there's such an extraordinary... She has such a sense of herself.
That's part of the contact she has with the audience, too, right. When she sings.
Oh, you've interviewed umpteen million people, Arlene. Do you notice that about people who are exceptionally good at something, that they have a sense of themselves?
Absolutely. It's no freak that those are the people that get to the top. If they have a real sense of themselves and have talent to go with it, as indeed you have, you go to the top.
Well, it really is remarkable, because she's really in there.
Yeah.
Well, listen, Donna, you were smashing this week.
Well, thank you.
Smashing. You must come back and play with us.
I will. Thank you. I'd love to.
Jerry, you was dynamite.
Thanks, pal.
It's always good to have you on the show.
I certainly enjoyed it.
Good luck
with the play. I'm in the Yellow Pages under Fair.
And also under Lovely. Arlene, you were terrific. Have fun, everybody. We'll see you. Goodbye.